So you've shopped around and found the threat intelligence platform you want to use in MISP. Great choice. Let me show you how to get up and running with it right now. MISP is the de facto open source threat intelligence platform used worldwide to share, collate, analyze, and distribute threat intelligence. Installing it can be very simple or very complicated, depending on what method you choose. I will show you them all and then walk you through how to install it the easiest way for a production environment. MISP can be installed in various ways. You can test it out using a virtual image, run it bare metal using the open source code on GitHub, or install it using a Docker container. Let's look at these three methods and which is right for you, starting off with the simplest, downloading the virtual machine. If you want to test MISP without going through the pain of installation, you can download a VMware or VirtualBox image directly from the project's download page. The MISP team creates a new virtual machine image at each core commit, so you can try it out and see the latest features. However, these images are for testing only and should not be used in a production environment. They lack a thorough security review, do not come with the latest MISP modules, and are difficult to integrate into a production workflow. I found the VirtualBox image great for understanding MISP and its capabilities, but it was a stripped down experience that was hard to integrate with other tools. If you want to experience MISP quickly, this is a great installation method. But if you want the full experience, you're going to need to look elsewhere. MISP is a relatively old project. It started back in 2011 as a way to share information about malware. Since then, it has grown into a threat intelligence platform used worldwide by everyone from independent researchers to large multinational organizations. The original way of installing MISP in a production environment was by cloning the open source GitHub repository and executing a bash script on a Linux server. This is still a popular installation method today, and you can find more details about how to install MISP this way on the project's GitHub page. That said, when I tried to install MISP this way, the installation script was buggy and it required manual debugging and rewriting to get a usable version of MISP. Bare metal is an option, but there is a much simpler way to get a production-ready version of MISP up and running. In the age of DevOps, there is a much better, or at least easier, way to install MISP than the buggy bare metal way. Through the power of Docker, a platform for creating, deploying, and running applications inside containers, you can spin up a MISP instance in a few commands, as I'll show you in the walkthrough. If you don't know what Docker is, I highly recommend taking the time to learn it. From now, just try to follow along, and trust me, this is the easiest way. Docker is my favorite installation method for any new software I run. It lets you easily control applications, run multiple applications at once from a single machine, and create virtual networks so applications can securely interact with the outside world. Before you install MISP using Docker, you need to set up a few things. Firstly, you need a Linux machine that can run Docker. In this demo, I will use Ubuntu Server 2204 LTS version and assume that you know how to create a Linux machine on your platform of choice, something like VMware, VirtualBox, or even Proxmox. Secondly, you need a MISP Docker image. There are a few floating around, but I will be using the MISP-Docker image. This is the latest and greatest MISP Docker image that is endorsed by the project itself. Finally, you need network access to the machine you are running MISP on, so that you can access the MISP dashboard, run modules, and ingest threat intelligence into your MISP instance. This usually means opening ports 443 and port 80 on the machine. If you are running MISP in a Type 2 hypervisor like VirtualBox, you may also need to create port forwarding rules so that your local machine can access the virtual one. once you have these prerequisites set up, you can start the installation process. Okay, so now we can start installing Docker. Firstly, we need to SSH into our machine. Here, I am running on localhost, set up with a port forwarding rule on port 222 to port 22 of the Linux machine. Once in, we can uninstall any previous versions of Docker. This cleans up any old versions and makes sure we don't run into any errors. To do this, we can use a bash for loop. Next, we need to add some packages that Docker will use to install its dependencies. These include CA certificates, curl, and GNU PG. Once those are installed, we can add the official Docker repo to our app package manager. Next, we can run a sudo apt update to make sure that it is there and we'll install Docker. Once this is done, we can install the required Docker packages. And we can make sure our install of Docker was successful by running the hello world image. Next, we can get started installing the MISP Docker image. To do this, firstly clone the GitHub repository, cd into this directory, copy the template.env file, and then edit the .env file you just created, changing the base URL variable. Here I have set mine to localhost and port 8080, which is set up as a port forwarding rule to port 443 on my virtual machine. Save out of that file and then run the sudo docker compose build command to build that MISP image. Once the MISP image is built, you can run the docker compose up command to start it up. You can then access the MISP image on port 443 of the host. Here I have a port forwarding rule set up on port 8080 to port 443 on the virtual machine. I need to accept the certificate, and there you have the MISP home screen. The first step to using your MISP instance is to log in using the default admin account. You can do this with the email admin admin.test with the password admin. Once you log in, you'll be greeted by the default MISP home screen. Next, you want to change this default admin password to something more secure. You can do this by clicking on admin and then selecting change password. Enter your new password and confirm it with the old admin password. Next, you want to add an organization, which you can do by going to administration and selecting add organizations. Here, you can enter the name of your administration, generate a UUID to identify it, fill in a description, and then specify any more details you would like. When you're done, click submit. You'll see your organization listed in the organizations page. Once you have your organization set up, you want to then start adding users to it. So we'll create an admin user for this organization. To do this, go to administration, add user, then fill out the user details. Select the organization you created, and then when you are done, click create user. You will then see that user in the users index. Next, you want to ensure you are running the latest MISP galaxies and taxonomies. MISP galaxies are a way to add structured threat information to a MISP event and are standardized in interoperable format. For instance, you can add a MITRE attack technique to describe how an attack was performed. MISP taxonomies are a way to classify a MISP event by adding a tag to it. A good example of this would be the traffic light protocol tag, or TLP, which you can add to a MISP event to classify how that intelligence should be handled and shared with others. You will want to update both MISP galaxies and taxonomies before starting anything else, or on a monthly basis while using the platform. To update your MISP galaxies and taxonomies, by going to Galaxies, List Galaxies, then clicking Update Galaxies. To update your taxonomies, go to Events, List Taxonomies, and click Update Taxonomies. With the taxonomies updated, you can now begin using them. I recommend starting out with the Traffic Light Protocol Taxonomy, or TLP, as a minimum to add context to how your intelligence should be handled and shared by others. To use a taxonomy, you must enable it. Here we will enable the TLP taxonomy for traffic light protocol. This is a good one to get started with. You can see that it's not enabled here, so we'll go across and click the play icon, which enables it. Now we'll go back to taxonomies, search for the enabled taxonomies, and here we have TLP. Now we need to select which tags we want to be active. We could enable all, but let's just specify which one specifically we want. To do this, click on the View Taxonomy button, and then we can select which taxonomies we want to enable. Here I will do Amber, Amber Strict, Clear, Green, and Red. You scroll to the right, and we see the Create Tag button. This will make sure they are enabled. Click Submit, then we can go back. Here you see we have one out of the eight enabled. And it is this TLP Amber. You can then do the rest for each of the tags you want to use. Once complete, you should see all of your taxonomies. These are the taxonomies that are used in TLP 2.0, and I highly recommend using them in your MISP instance. Okay, so now you have your MISP taxonomies, MISP galaxies up to date, and you have enabled the TLP protocol as a taxonomy in your MISP instance. You're all ready to get started adding threat intelligence into MISP and using it in your daily work. To do this, let's log out of this default admin account and log back in as the user we created for our test organization. To do this, click the logout button and use the email address and password you created for your user. Here, the user will be prompted to change their password from the default one that you set. They will then be greeted by their profile when they log in. Now you're ready to use MISP, start collecting, analyzing, and sharing threat intelligence. You have successfully installed MISP and are ready to add threat intelligence. Next time, we'll dive into actually using MISP by creating events, adding intelligence, and exporting IOCs so your security solutions can detect and block the latest threats.